Hey, this is my friend's jumper. I think she gave it to me on a cold afternoon when I was going home after a barbecue party.
This is my friend's jumper. He gave it to me because he got it for himself and then he decided he didn't like it.
I think the jumper has a big L on it. I think it's my friend's husband's jumper. I guess his name's Larsens.
Because I was borrowing it from him so much, he let me keep it. I've got quite a few things from this friend.
I used to see my friend all the time. She was a singer. I know her for a very long time. And then she met the Larsens guy and had the baby.
I've got quite a few things from this friend. All the things I have are things he's bought for himself and he's decided he doesn't like or it doesn't suit him anymore.
And then she moved away to Hong Kong. And now I don't see her that much anymore.
Now he says that the jumper doesn't suit me. He says it's too baggy. Maybe he thinks that I should give it away.
So, this is the jumper.
Oh yeah,
the jumper. This is the jumper. I really like a friend really comfortable. It has like a big L. A Larsens team lifetime member. It's my friend's husband's jumper, I guess, because his surname is Larsen.
Mm-hmm.
And this jumper I got from my friend when we had a barbecue at my friend's house, and we had wanted to cycle back home. And I asked my friend if I could borrow a jumper because it was cold, but in the evening I borrowed a jumper and we were cycling back home with my friend. My friend is actually quite drunk and she dropped her bag cycling and she didn't notice. I picked it up. But if she was cycling behind me, she would probably lose her bag, like her handbag. But so this jumper, and then I use it for running sometimes when I go running. Mm. I wear it. But now my friend moved away to Hong Kong with the baby and his husband.
Mm.
And she said that I could keep the jumper.
I've known Sophie for about 4 years. I met her at her first dance class that she taught for the dance company I eventually ended up working for when I was about 16. I loved her dance classes because of the emphasis that she put on creating and improvising movement and how much we as students had a role in the creation of the dances we performed. I got to know her a bit more when I started supporting her lessons and helped to teach kids. I got to see how and why she would structure the lesson the way she did, the way she would use the exercises as a way to build up from creating for themselves. After a few years of doing her dance classes, a year before I went off to go to uni, I moved in with her and her daughter and a couple of her friends. During this time, I found out how much of a hard worker she was and how much she had to juggle. She's a single parent to an 8-year-old girl, a lecturer at uni, a freelance teacher for a dance company, and a creative director and choreographer for her own company. I don't know how she did it all. She had so much energy. She was always on the move, always doing something. and she approached everything with positivity. I'm thankful for the things she's taught me. I admire her quite a lot. Before I moved to uni, she left herself to Geneva with her daughter to live with her boyfriend. I don't really speak to her anymore. She pops up on Facebook every now and then, or sends me a link through an email, showing me dance classes that she thinks will be good for me. And I reply back, but it kind of just ends there. Maybe I'll send her a video of this performance and see what she has to say. I'd love her opinion.
On Monday, I brought Nathan in and put him in the locker, along with Mum, Sophie, Esther, Eva and Claire, who I put in on Saturday. I wanted to bring them all back home, but it would have been too much to carry when picking up Jedza. When I got home, I put Moira, Claire and Esther in the wash. On Tuesday, I brought Sophie in to play around with her. I love what I've made so far. On Wednesday, Claire, Esther and Moira was still wet. And then, I don't know, I couldn't really tell if it was just a cold room or what, but it means that I couldn't wear the clothes I wanted to wear, I suppose. So I just wore a black top instead. On Thursday, I brought Karen and Sophie in. I wanted to play around with them more, but I didn't really have time. It's quite busy that day. On Friday, I brought Moira and Nathan together. It looked okay.
Hiya.
Oh yeah, you alright?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Alright. Yeah, I was just calling because I'm doing recording things at the moment and
yeah.
It's a bit random, but do you remember the Rachel Priest labels that you used to sew into my school uniform?
Yeah.
Yeah. Could you talk about them? How did you get them, and why did you get them? Why did you choose to get a Rachel Priest label instead of just writing it in my uniform?
yeah.
Can you talk about it?
I'll be in chocolate in a minute. Do you want me to do it now?
Yeah. Or you could record yourself. Maybe. Okay, well, you could talk about it now, just so I know what you're going to say, and then I can then record it.
I'm
from
Takiri.
Okay.
So, it's just a matter of course that I bought stuff for you and Ed stuff.
Mm.
And I bought them because every time you write on things on the school uniform, all the small stuff, it was got smudgy, so you couldn't see it, so it's it was better actually sewing it in, and you could read the name.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know it's a bit random, but yeah.
I've got them.
Yeah, I've got them with me. Yeah, I nicked them out of the sewing box. No, I've got a baby.
Ah, yeah, see?
Right, thank you. Cool, that's it.